Hi there, I'm Christopher Harrison, Senior Program Manager inside of Microsoft Cloud and AI. And what I want to take a look at now is how we can start to configure routes inside of our Express app. A route at its core is how it is that a client or user can request something, be it data, be it an operation, or otherwise, from our application. Basically, what's going to happen is the client will specify a URL, they'll maybe send up some information, and then that will cause a function to execute in response to that. Now, the way that we're going to set this up is we're going to create a router here. So we'll set up our router and set that equal to the cool little router that Express makes available to us. Now, what you're going to notice about the router is that we're going to be able to specify the method or verb that we want to now look for. So this could be get, this could be patch, this could be post, this could be put, etc. Now, those different verbs will have different meanings, and we'll see those in later videos. For now, though, let's focus in on get, which is sort of the core on how we're going to start everything off. Now, what we'll do with the first parameter is specify the path, and this is that little forward slash, that's going to specify that this is now the default. So if the user just navigates to that core URL, this is what we're going to do in response to that. The handler that we're going to give it is going to take two parameters, request, which is going to contain any information that was sent up from the user, and response, which is how we're going to send information down to the user. For our little demo, what we want to do is send down the description and the version of our application, and we're going to retrieve that from the package.json file. So we'll go ahead and import that in. And then what we'll do is we'll use that response object and send down, in our case, a string. So we'll use the string format, we'll go ahead and go grab the description from the package, and we'll grab the version from the package, and we will send that down. And there's a little bit of a typo here that we'll go ahead and clean up in just a second. There we go. So now this is set up. So it's gonna send down that formatted string. The last step here, after we've got that set up, is to actually register our router with the app. So we're going to set up an API root, which is going to be API, and that's kind of a standard convention. And then we're going to tell our app to use that. So we're going to specify our API root, and then we're going to add in our router. So let's go ahead and save this, and we'll let NodeMon then refresh it. And then we're going to use a neat little package here called Simple REST Client that will allow us to go ahead and make these requests. This is an extension inside of Visual Studio Code. So we'll specify our URL, /API, our method of get. We'll send this, and what we're going to notice is that the response is that string that we have put together. And this really is sort of that core to everything that we're going to be doing with our applications, that we'll create a route, we'll specify some function that's going to respond to it, and then send down whatever information it is that the user has requested. In the next section, we're going to take a look at how we can continue to build on this by adding in a little bit of data.